Welcome back to the WDSU News Hot Seat again. I'm Norman Robinson, and tonight we're focusing on crime prevention and looking at it from a unique perspective. We are continuing our conversation now with the city's Criminal Justice Commissioner, James Carter, who's told us that he's not the first. Clarence DeRusso or Joe DeRusso was the first. That's Clarence DeRusso's brother, who was the police chief once upon a time.
Yes, sir.
Going back a little bit on my history, let you know I'm old, but I'm not that forgetful. In the 90s, former Chief of Police Richard Pennington vowed to cut the murder rate in half, and he did. Ironically, the current police chief, Ronald Surpass, who was a member of Pennington's top command, is only aiming for a 5% reduction in the murder rate. What do you think about that?
Well, first of all, that was a draft internal document. The chief and I talked, the mayor, and we've talked, and the mayor has set a vision that the hope and prayer and through our hard, earnest work is to make sure that we don't have any murders in the city of New Orleans to the best of our abilities. So we've been working together, the chief and I, on a ongoing, earnest basis, communicating, coordinating activities to make sure we properly engage in this holistic approach to dealing with this particular problem. Like I said, what we've done is we have plotted the anatomy of murder here in the city by scholars who have studied this particular matter. We're now in the process of plotting assets in the city of New Orleans. We're plotting assets by planning districts. We're plotting assets by neighborhoods. We're plotting assets by the smallest geographical unit of government, which are census tracts, to drill down on what assets do we have in order to determine what factors encourage the evolving and the maturing of negative behavior in neighborhoods. We need to figure out, well, what's in those neighborhoods or not in those neighborhoods that we need to make sure that we produce the sort of individuals we want in our society. And so what we've been doing, we have gathered over 875 asset points within the various neighborhoods. We are starting to organize individuals to deal with this so that we can address this issue from the mayor's vision of finding out what we need to produce what we need to produce and grow the type of individuals we want in the community.
Okay, I'd be the first to admit I'm not the brightest bulb in the pack, but did you answer the question about what you think about the chief's saying he can only reduce murder about 5%? I didn't get it.
What I said was that we, the chief, the mayor, and everybody that's a part of this administration, our desire is to make sure that to the best of our abilities to reduce murder completely in the city of New Orleans.
Okay. 5% goal was just what then?
That was an internal document for discussion purposes and what we are trying to do. But again, the chief and I meet on a weekly basis. It is our desire, and we're working towards putting together resources. We just got resources with regard to the Bloomberg philanthropic organization.
I saw that.
We applied for, with the chief's support, a $2.2 million grant to the Department of Justice to implement the ceasefire initiative. And again, going back to what we are doing, we are first studying the anatomy of murder. We are then looking at assets that we need in the city of New Orleans, taking those assets and determining whether or not we have the proper assets to interdict, interrupt, intervene in these affairs to prevent these murders from happening. We're also looking at progressive arrest models, progressive incarceration models and prosecution models and rehabilitation models, because oftentimes individuals, after they've had their stint in the criminal justice system, are looking for a way to matriculate back into society in a progressive way. So when they come out, we want to make sure that the business community is paused to give these individuals opportunities who have felony convictions to become great players in the community. So what we are doing is we're taking the very best knowledge from around the country. We looked at 50 best practices from around the country in crime reduction. We've sought back to what we did, he and I, when we were with the Weed and Seed program here in the city of New Orleans. We're looking at the ceasefire model in Chicago. We're looking at the Harlem's Children's Zone. We're looking at stuff that's going on in Newark, New Jersey. We're looking at the poverty rates. We're looking at a lot of things so that when we make these recommendations, that we are intelligent and smart, and then ultimately we will collectively, holistically reduce the murder rate here in the city of New Orleans.
So lastly, is it fair to say that the Criminal Justice Commissioner and the police chief are looking at a 100% reduction in the murder rate?
It is fair to say that we're looking to make sure that we are in a city that doesn't have the occurrence, make homicide obsolete here in the city of New Orleans. And it is the mayor's number one priority, public safety. And I am so happy to be here to deal with this particular issue because it's a lifelong work of mine. And I'm very excited to be back in this particular capacity.
Well, I hope you'll come back and discuss with us further this particular issue because there's a lot to be talked about.
Yes.
All right. We only scratched the surface.
Yes.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Carter.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. That is our show for this evening. Now back to the news. Back to the news.